8:40.
Turning a memoir about depression into a music album is no mean feat, is it? But Matt Haig's book, Reasons to Stay Alive, Andy Burrows, who used to be a drummer in Razorlight, they sort of came together and they've managed to do it.
Yes, and it's an extraordinary thing. The marriage of rock and literature came about after they both experienced issues with their mental health. And Andy reached out to Matt on Twitter. It's an amazing story. Before we speak to them, let's have a listen. Andy Burrows and Matt Haig join us now. Morning, both. Thank you very much.
Lovely to see you both.
So that's a bit of the music that you've made together. Who wants to take up the story? It all started with a tweet.
Andy.
Well, I tweeted on. Matt. I was away on tour and sort of thinking of a reason to make a new album.
Yeah.
And I love Matt on Twitter. I think he's a fascinating man. And so I tweeted him and said, would you be up for working with me? And he got back to me the next morning and...
Yes.
And here you are.
That was 2 years ago, Valentine's Day.
Our anniversary.
Yeah.
but you are an author. This is something
totally
very different,
new.
Isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, it's still writing. I did literally none of the music, so which is fortunate for the album. So I was just I was just words. But yeah, we started...
We did want you to come and sing.
Yeah. Well, I was in the middle of writing a book at the time, and it was a bit stressful. I was writing a book called Notes on a Nervous Planet, and it was a book about mental health. And so he asked me to sort of do some song lyrics. And I thought it'd be interesting to talk about mental health in a different kind of way, in a less sort of expositional, explainy kind of way. Mm. So I just wrote stuff that was on my mind at that point. And I think songs and song lyrics can do stuff that books can't. You can sort of like be emotional in a more abstract kind of way.
So for people who don't know, you've written a book, it's called Reasons to Stay Alive, and so is the album.
Yeah.
You read that book, had you, and others by Matt?
I'd read A Boy Called Christmas, which I loved, and I was in the middle of Reasons when we started talking, but yeah, it's an incredible book.
And why did it resonate with you? What was that connection that you had with it?
I mean, I've had a lot of depression around me, and like we all have, family and friends and stuff, but anxiety particularly I really sort of suffer with. But I the way Matt writes just really appealed. I found it sort of therapeutic.
So you wrote the words, exactly the words, or how did it work?
Yeah, I think there's one word that Andy changed in Barcelona. He changed phone, about phoning someone, and he changed it to call. But
that was your lyrical input.
I'm a lyricist.
But that was more than my musical input. I wasn't even doing the maracas. It was just like totally. But I think because we had a clear line, I was just words, he was just the music. We both left each other to it. And weirdly, when I heard the songs, there was such beauty. Andy's such a sort of genius musician that when I heard the music, there was no other possible tune for those words.
Right, yeah.
Yeah, even though I hadn't got those tunes in my head.
Something you posted this morning, because I know you've written about sort of the perils of Twitter as well, and I really like this you said this morning. I wish I could go back 5 years and tell my naive self that someone being snarky and angry at you on Twitter is not a reason to ruin your day.
Yeah.
It means nothing. Twitter's main use is as a magnet that pulls out the snark from people so they can function less bitterly at work.
Yeah, well, I've had a very weird relationship with Twitter. I'd spent far too much of the last 10 years arguing with strangers on there, like many people do, or getting into pointless political things. And that's why I wrote that book I was telling you about, Notes on a Nervous Planet, just to sort of process that and wonder what it is actually doing to our minds all this time and our mental health, what we're doing.
I suppose the positive thing is that social media, for all its perils, it has actually brought you together.
Yeah, I mean, I think that's a good thing, you know. I mean, that was very much a modern meeting, you know, a social media success.
Yeah, the whole Reasons to Stay Alive album wouldn't have existed without us sort of...
Big up Twitter.
And here it is. Oh.
There it is.
Hi, Matt, how are you? Would you like to do something together? That sounds great. and an album comes out of this.
There we go. He slid into my DMs.
I was very nervous when I sent that tweet to you, though. I thought I'd done... You know, I woke up the next morning, I was like, oh, dear. maybe that was a bit embarrassing to send a famous author a sort of a note pleading with him, will you work with me?
It's easier than walking across the room to someone, I suppose, isn't it? You can actually have the confidence to reach out to someone that you don't know.
So I read your book yesterday, and there's so much in it for lots of different people, whether they have depression, anxiety themselves. Mm. There's also, you talk as well, as I say, really, really key information and things to help with people. There's also, you give a lot of information about people surrounding people who are depressed, because that's a lot of thing we talk about here.
Yeah.
How can friends help? And you sort of do deal with that as well.
Absolutely, and I feel like often people are worried about the right words to use or what to say. I think for me, the thing that really helped me when I was in a sort of suicidal place, and I was quite ill with panic disorder, depression, anxiety for about 3 years, was having someone, parents, a girlfriend, who I could just talk to, who I could explain things. None of these people were doctors or experts or medical professionals, although I did speak to them too, but they... It was just having some to have a valve where you could sort of externalize something that's very internal. And I think mainly it's just about listening and actually trying to understand something that's very invisible, yet so universal.
And not all the songs on the album are about mental health. You mentioned Barcelona. Should we have a little listen to that? Because this is essentially, what's Barcelona about? It's about
Barcelona.
A nice trip to Barcelona.
although actually it is a happy song, but it's also, Barcelona was, when I was ill with mental health stuff, I was always remembering the happy time that me and my girlfriend had spent in Barcelona before. So it's a song being remembered in a panic attack. But yes, it's a very happy, happy sound.
Let's listen to it.
This is Barcelona.
I mean, you know, and as you say, that is not, it does not sound like a depressing, sad song, that, at all, is it?
No, and hopefully the album is it. I think it's a very, like, and Andy's sort of taking it as well, but I was trying to be optimistic with what I was writing, and I think it is about mental health, but not in a sort of negative doom and gloom way. It's very much a sort of, hopefully it's like a little... audible therapy.
It's exactly what it says on the tin. Reasons to stay alive.
Something else in the pipeline? Another album? Or something?
Well, it was just so fun, so I think we've got to do more.
It was a lot of fun. It was a joy to write with him. It was...
We're doing a musical next. I think that's what
we're... Just put that out there. You said it now.
Having you on today has reminded me of a great quote I read about social media once from somebody who's talking about allowing it to affect your life too much. He said, you've got to remember, whenever you read something you don't like, just remember that Twitter, particularly, he was saying, Twitter is a powerful tool that gives power to tools. so don't allow them to get in your head.
Right, you've told me that a few times. Me too, Mark.
Really good to see you. Thank you so much. Thank you very much.
And the album, as we said, is called Reasons to Stay Alive. Thanks, both.
And if you do a musical, you can come back and tell us about that a little bit later on.
Cheers.